this video, let's learn about the root finding functions provided by MATLAB. Most of the time, you don't need to code your own root finding function like we did when we drew the Newton fractal. Instead, you can just use the built-in MATLAB functions. There are two main root finding functions in MATLAB. There is a function that you can use to find all the real and complex roots of a polynomial. This function is called roots, and you only need to give it the polynomial's coefficients. There is another function that you can use to find one real root of a nonlinear function. This is a very useful function and is called fzero. You only need to give this function an initial guess for the root. If you like, you could also give it a two-component vector that brackets the root. Let's start with the function roots. We want to solve a polynomial equation that looks like p sub 1 x to the n plus p sub 2 x to the n minus 1 plus dot 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 plus p sub n plus 1 equals 0. So an nth degree polynomial has n plus 1 coefficients, and we need to order the coefficients from the highest degree to the lowest. We define a vector p with elements p1, p2, through p sub n plus 1. Don't forget to include zeros if any of the powers are missing. The correct call is r equals roots of p, where r will be the n complex roots stored in a column vector. Let's try it in MATLAB. So let's try and solve the polynomial equation, x cubed minus 3x squared plus 4x minus 2 equals 0. I'll do it in the live editor. We need to just define the polynomial's coefficients. So we set p equal to the coefficients of the polynomial starting at the highest power. So 1 times x cubed, and then minus 3 times x squared, plus 4 times x, minus 2. Once we have the coefficients defined, then we can find the roots. So we can set the roots r equal to the roots. MATLAB is being helpful here and tells us how to call roots. So we give it our p. And that should do it. I can come here to the live editor and then hit run. And then on the right here, we see the r, because I didn't put a semicolon here. So r is complex. 1 plus I, 1 minus I, and 1. We see that 1 must have a very small round-off error in the imaginary part, but we cannot help that. We can set it to real if we needed to use, if we needed to determine, say, one real root. Is 1 a root? We should check that. 1 cubed is 1, minus 3 times 1 is, so that would be 1 minus 3 is minus 2, plus 4 is 2, minus 2 equals 0. So 1 is a root. So we just found all the complex roots of a polynomial. Now let's look at the fzero function. Fzero can find one root of a nonlinear function. So let's solve the equation f of x equals 0. We need to define f as either an anonymous function or a subfunction. Most problems will have parameters in addition to x, so we need to include them also. The proper call to f0 then looks like this, where by using add of x, we are telling f0 that we want to solve for x in the equation f of x with some parameters equals 0. We also need to give f0 an initial guess for the root in the variable x0, just like in Newton's method, or a bracket for the root when x0 is a length 2 vector, just like in the bisection method. In most applications, it's more common to give a value of x0 close to the root. Let's try it in MATLAB. Let's solve the nonlinear equation x equals e to the minus ax. A will be a parameter. Here we'll set a equal to 1/2, but I want to show you how to call f0 with a function that also has parameter values. So we need to define our function. So we can set f equal to, we use this at symbol and say that it's a function both of x and parameters. Here the parameter is a. And that's the function we want to find the zero of. So if we're solving x equals e to the minus ax, we want to find the zero of x minus e to the minus ax. E is the exponential function, and that will be of minus a times x. Okay, so that defines the function. We can then set the parameter. So here we'll set the parameter equal to 1/2. We can say 0.5, it doesn't matter. We need an initial guess for the root. We can try 0, see if it converges. 0 is not a very good guess because that would say 0 equal to e to the 0, which is 1, or 0 equals 1, but it turns out to converge. Finally, then we can try and find the root using f0. So we have r, the root, is going to be equal to f0. MATLAB is trying to help us here. That's a root of a nonlinear function. And then it tells us what the arguments are supposed to be. The first argument is the function. We can use this at symbol again and say that the function is a function of x because we have a parameter. But f0 is expecting a function that is a function of only one variable. So we can use this at of x, and then give pass it f, which is a function both of x and our parameter a. Okay, the next argument then is the initial guess, and here it will just be x0. That should do it. That should find the root r. We can go to our live editor and hit run. And we see that we return r equals 0.7035. In this video, I've introduced you to two root finding functions, roots.m and fzero.m. Roots is used to find all the zeros of a polynomial, and f0 is used to find one zero of any nonlinear function. I personally have used f0 many times in my research. It's a very powerful and simple function to use. You can try it out in some of the problems that I give you in this course. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.